You're watching ZTV.
You're watching ZTV.
Goodness, I bless you in Jesus' name and authority, and I pray that you are enjoying this season with him. It's a new year, lots of new things going on. Lots of people are in transition. I'm in transition, been in it for a long time and ready to be out of it. But God knows best, and because my timeline is increasingly being aligned with his original design for me, I know that I'm going to be where I need to be when I'm supposed to be at the right time that I'm supposed to be there. So I'm not trying to rush it. Today, I want to share a dream with you that I had on Saturday, October 6th, and give you a little bit of the information. So a week or two, or possibly even three ago, I posted on one of my sites, and I tried to find the post and I couldn't, but it's either on zwordswords.org on ZTV, or it's on zm7academy.us on the prophecy page, which is where the blog is. And I was writing that I'm trying to get some deliverance from one curse that's active in my life. It's a big one. It's causing a lot of problems and a lot of blockage. And so I didn't have any tools for it. I mean, I went to my mentors. Patty and I, of course, have been praying for it for years. Tam and I have been praying for it for years. Selena and I have been praying for it for at least a year, maybe even longer than that. But yeah, longer than a year. So almost 2 years, if not longer than that. So I have just, you know, was completely out of the possibility in all that I could find, all the research that I was doing and all that stuff. And even my own prayer, you know, our prayers of agreement, all stuff. I could not find any tools that would help me get through and break this curse. So finally, what I decided to do is I was like, OK, Holy Spirit, I'm just going to sit with you. I'm going to submit myself to you. I'm going to pray and allow you to do what needs to be done so that I can actually break this curse and move on to the portion of my life that involves the treasure that's being blocked by this curse. So I had this dream. Well, I did that, you know, for a couple of weeks, sitting and submitting to the Lord, probably not even a couple of weeks. He was quick on this, you know, because maybe it was just one of those things where it was like, well, just when she asked the right question, then I'm going to turn on the power and give her what she needs. But for whatever reason, I got some huge deliverance in this dream that I had on Saturday, October 6th. So here's the dream. So I dreamed my sister had a crazy thug boyfriend, and we all were going somewhere in a car that he was driving. So my sister, him, and myself were all going somewhere in a car he was driving. My sister was in the passenger seat, and she was like in fear, you know, of him because he was so out of control. And we were going somewhere to get something to eat. And when we got to the place to get some food, she and I were still outside. She never got out of the passenger seat of the car the whole time of the dream. So he's inside acting a fool, and I'm standing outside the car looking into the restaurant type place. And I'm like, this is ridiculous. I got to get us away from him because I'm the deliverer of my family, of course. So I come to get into the car, and the car has become a Honda Odyssey van. It's no longer whatever little car he was driving us in, but my sister's still in the passenger front seat. So I get in the car and I'm trying to start this car, but this car will not start at all. You know, it'll start up a little bit and then sputter out and stuff. So I'm having a hard time getting us out of the car, and I'm trying to hurry, you know, because this man's crazy and I want to get us away from him. The next thing I know, my son Zane's in the next back row of the van. And then a friend of my sister's pulls up beside her on the passenger side and is like, I'm here to help. It's some girl. And then so she gets out of her car and then jumps in the van. So now there are four of us in the van. I'm in the driver's seat trying to get this car going. And suddenly there are people and other cars and all kind of stuff. Everything you can imagine is in the road blocking me. So I finally got the car running, but I can't go anywhere because there are people around blocking. There are other cars around blocking. And then, of course, the crazy man realized that we're trying to get away. So he comes up and he's on the driver's side with the shotgun threatening us like, you guys aren't going anywhere. And so I'm trying to get this car moved, trying to do everything I can to get this car moved. And finally, I just gun it and drive over the grass, over, you know, those little cement dividers that stop you so you don't go any further when you're parking and stuff like that. I drove over all of that stuff and just to get us away from him. But the thing is, we're moving so slow. This guy's able to walk and keep up with us all this time, pointing the shotgun at us, threatening us like he's going to shoot us. But he never does. He never shoots. So we get out into the middle of the street. I'm barely moving, like inching along. Like, seriously, this guy is walking beside the car. That's how slow we're moving. But we are getting away. or we're actually moving forward is what it is. We haven't quite gotten away yet. So eventually I just stop the van in the middle of the road and I get out to confront the man and I try to grab the shotgun from him. And when I do that, I realize this is too light. It either has maybe one shell in it or no shells at all. So I was like, well, bump this. I'm not going to be running from this guy. He doesn't actually have any real bullets. So I kicked him in the nutcracker and he fell back, passed out like that had killed him practically. And then so I put that dream out to the world asking, you know, for all kind of help and interpretation to see if anybody had anything. And nobody had a whole lot for me. But it was really interesting. Like Patty was saying, oh, my gosh, this dream is really, really interesting. I'm intrigued by it. So I spent some time Saturday night and I spent like probably about an hour and 20 minutes just sitting with the Holy Spirit and going over this dream. And he revealed some fantastic things to me. So I have the dream here on my notes, but I actually didn't bring the interpretations and stuff that Holy Spirit gave me. So I'm going to pause and go grab that other journal and then come back and share with you that information. So I'll be right back with you in a second. Stay tuned.
Hi, this is Zari. If you've enjoyed supping on the Word of God with me today, I invite you to partner with me in this kingdom work. Your partnership in this fertile soil gives you legal access to every anointing my ministry operates in, multiplied, because that's my decree for you. Thank you, and be exceedingly blessed in Jesus' name.